All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Mark Ireton. He is the CEO of Victory Battery Metals. And Mark, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Thanks, Steve. Nice to be here.
Yeah, and also joining us is your geologist, Helgi Sigurgeirson. And Helgi, great to see you.
Yeah, good to see you too.
So looking forward to getting some thoughts from Helgi on a number of the properties, especially the ones that he's visited recently. But before we do that, Mark, I thought it'd be a great opportunity to update what's going on at your properties in James Bay, because lots of news right now, obviously, about fires in the area. So maybe you could provide a bit of an update for everyone.
Yeah, that's true. It's our Stingray property. It's just south of Patriot Battery Metals Corvette property. They've had some huge success there. We have a work program underway. We are planning to get up there in mid-August. We've been pushed back due to forest fires and whatnot, but we are looking forward to complete a work program there in August. It's difficult to get to. It's by helicopter access, and the helicopters are going first to fight forest fires. So we have been delayed there, but it is on track.
Okay, good stuff. Good to hear that. Let's talk about some of your other projects as well, because you did release a shareholder update that sort of backed up everything that's been happening with the company. And obviously, Smokey, your lithium project in Nevada, is big talk as well. So what can you tell us about Smokey?
Yeah, it's our real flagship property, our low-hanging fruit, if you will. It's about 15 miles north of Clayton Valley, and there's been some very decent clay-hosted lithium discoveries there, and 25 miles south of American Lithium's TLC deposit. We completed phase two of a drill program there this year. And we learned in the first hole drilled this year lined up pretty smartly with the last hole drilled last year. So we've got a nice trend happening there. And, you know, it ties in quite well with, and our results are very similar to American Lithium's discovery, which is some high-grade lithium there. And, you know, in the history of lithium exploration, that type of high-grade result is not known to exist in isolation. So we're really determined to focus on that property and learn the full extent of the deposit there.
Okay. I know that you had Helgi out on Georgia Lake and also on Tahlo Lake, and we'll get to his thoughts on those two properties. But just in general, Mark, those are really interesting for the company as well.
They are. Georgia Lake property, another lithium play. It's Thunder Bay, Ontario. It's only 2 miles east of Rocktech's property, a nice discovery there again. There are the amenities there, you know, infrastructure-wise and whatnot, close to Trans-Canada Highway. So it's a project that is relatively accessible, and so we do carry on that. We have completed. Helgi's team has gone out there and put boots on the ground there. There's some lab results we're waiting on to determine what the next program will be there. And then there's Tahlo Lake. It's a copper play in BC. It is, I believe, about a 5,600 acre property. And again, Helgi's been out there with his team. It was easy accessible. There was logging roads there that made his job a little easier. Again, he's got some lab results sent in from the samples that he's taken, and we're waiting on those results also.
Yeah, Helgi, let's bring you in the conversation, because as I mentioned, you were on both of those properties. So obviously some detailed work. Let's go to with Tahlo Lake first. Talk about the program there and what you were seeing when you were on site.
All right. Well, Tahlo Lake to start with is it's good geology there. Like we're sort of following up on NAC's successes in the area, the NAC project, I guess, with American Eagle. It's basically, it's It's got the right kind of regional faulting, the right Jurassic strata. It's got regional mag highs. It looked like an interesting place to look. When we got in there, we had a couple of positive discoveries right off the hop. As Mark mentioned, loggers have been in there recently and opened up access a lot on the southern part of the property. Very helpful. And while doing that, they also put in a borrow pit, sort of a road cut zone that we're calling it the road cut showing, because immediately we found copper mineralization, which is very encouraging, the first outcrop you look at on a property. So a fairly good alteration, chalcopyrite, bornite. So that an excellent start for sure.
Yeah, that's good. And how about Georgia Lake? Tell me about on that property as well, and your thoughts when you first got on there.
Georgia Lake, the interest for us there is that, you know, obviously we're right next to RockTech's property. And there you find the lithium-bearing pegmatites are associated with these mica granites, which they only found on the property through drilling. So there's at least, well, there's three trends of these in granitic trends toward our property, some from RockTech's ground, two from the east. So when we went in there and on our initial reconnaissance program, we actually found a couple areas of previously unmapped intrusives, suggesting there is more to find and these trends are potentially continuing onto our property. And we also took quite a few till samples as well, which are results pending on. But so far, yeah, and results have been encouraging.
Yeah. Mark, just wrapping up here, I know that it's lots of work that Helgi's continuing to do and the rest of the team as well. And it sounds like there's going to be a lot of news flow over the next little while as you really start to work this portfolio.
Yeah, very much, Steve. You know, our lithium property in Nevada, it's a very friendly mining state. After phase two drill program, we're looking to advance that property. It's a prolific area, mining friendly. Georgia Lake Lithium, again, a prolific area there beside RockTech, a nice discovery. There is a lot of buzz in James Bay, Quebec. Patriot Battery Metals has got some significant finds there. We're very, very close to that property, and we're looking forward to get out there, kick that tire, and see what lies underground for us. Tahlo Lake with the copper property. Helgi's been there, done that. We are looking to advance that project as well. Lots of these battery metals seems to be our focus these days. And we can't wait to give shareholders an update on our next round of attack on these respective properties.
All right. We look forward to sharing with everyone. Helgi, thanks very much. Great to talk to you. Appreciate it.
No, you're welcome. Happy to be here.
All right, there's Helgi Sigurgeirson. He's the geologist. And of course, Mark, always nice to talk to you as well.
Absolutely, Steve. The best to you. And thanks for having us today.
Absolutely. And there's Mark Ireton, the CEO of Victory Battery Metals.